Niech będzie pochwalony Jezus Chrystus. Witamy serdecznie pielgrzymów polskich. Oprócz osób i rodzin, które przybyły indywidualnie, są tu obecne dwie grupy pielgrzymów z Opola. Szczególnie serdecznie witamy i pozdrawiamy pary nowożeńców. Przygotowując się na spotkanie z Ojcem Świętym, przypominamy, że bilety wstępu na audiencję są zawsze darmowe i wydawane wyłącznie przez prefekturę domu papieskiego. Ponadto informujemy, że po zakończeniu audiencji dla chętnych będzie możliwość uczestniczenia w mszy świętej dla pielgrzymów, odprawianej w Bazylice Świętego Piotra o godzinie 12. Jego świątobliwość, znakiem krzyża i pozdrowieniem liturgicznym, rozpocznie za chwilę to spotkanie. Przygotujmy się do przyjęcia Jego słowa i otrzymania Jego błogosławieństwa.
Lauded to Jesus Christus, praise be Jesus Christ. Welcome to the live broadcast of the Holy Father, Pope Francis, Wednesday General Audience, 26 October. We're coming to you live from St. Peter's Square here in the Vatican. My name is Father Paul Samasumo, and I'll be providing the English language commentary and translation of texts for today's Wednesday General Audience. To start with, allow me to acknowledge our partner television and radio stations of Luminous Radio, Radio Maria Papua New Guinea, Radio Maria England, Catholic Faith Network, Catholic TV, Shalom World TV, Salt and Light TV, Atmadashan TV, EWTN TV. To those of you following us on our Vatican News website, or on our social media channels, on shortwave radio, and other diocesan radio stations, welcome. We are glad that you found time to join Pope Francis for the Wednesday General Audience. Those of you watching us right now on live TV, Facebook, or YouTube, you are seeing Pope Francis making the rounds of St. Peter in his Pope Mobile, as he often does. He is accompanied by a few children, whom he has given a lift to, and they are enjoying the ride around St. Peter's Square. Definitely something that they are going to treasure and remember for a long time as they grow. Pope Francis does the rounds of the square every Wednesday morning before the general audience to greet the various pilgrims who are in the square and get closer to them in some way. Last evening, Pope Francis took part in the closing ceremony and prayer service held at Rome's Colosseum. The three-day peace summit was hosted by the community of Sant'Egidio. It brought together religious leaders from Christianity, Judaism, Islam, Buddhism, Sikhism, and Hinduism. All these leaders were gathered in the Colosseum last evening to pray and plead for peace in the world. The Peace Summit was held under the theme, Il Grido della Pace, the cry for peace. Pope Francis attended the last day where there was the prayer service to pray for peace. And speaking during the peace summit, Pope Francis said that this year was a heartfelt plea for peace because he felt a heartfelt plea for peace because today peace has been gravely violated, assaulted, and trampled upon. The Holy Father feels saddened that a continent such as Europe, which in the last century endured the horrors of world wars, could still condone war. Wars cause bloodshed and impoverish the earth, Pope Francis said last evening. The Pope also said peace cannot be suppressed because it rises from the hearts of mothers and that it is deeply etched on the faces of refugees, displaced families, the wounded, and the dying because of the war. And speaking of refugees who are the casualties of wars and conflict, the religious leaders who were at the peace summit yesterday at the Colosseum here in Rome listened to a moving testimony of a Nigerian woman who is a refugee in Italy. Her name is Esther Iweze Adeizi from Nigeria. She shared her harrowing experience in Libya, where she was detained by some gunmen after fleeing conflict in Nigeria. When she arrived in Nigeria, she was taken into captivity by some gunmen, and for 6 years, her captors kept her as a slave. They only released her when they thought that she was about to die. She somehow survived, and her plight came to the attention of the Sant'Egidio community, who rescued her through their project known as the Humanitarian Corridors from Libya. So that was the peace summit of yesterday that Pope Francis attended. And now coming back to the audience, Pope Francis still doing the rounds in his Pope Mobile here in the square. A rather cloudy, misty morning today. You are always welcome to attend the Wednesday General Audience. It is open to everyone, Catholics and non-Catholics. Papal audiences are held on Wednesday mornings in the Vatican Square, usually. When it is cold, when the weather is not permitting, sometimes the papal audiences are held in the Paul the Sixth Hall, which is just here in the Vatican. Pilgrims and visitors in Rome have an opportunity to see the Pope and receive the apostolic blessing during the Wednesday General Audience. The Wednesday audience with the Pope consists of short teachings and scripture readings, mainly in Italian. These are then translated by various persons in English, French, German language, Spanish, Polish, Portuguese, and Arabic. And during the audience, the Pope greets the individual visitors who are present, as well as the various pilgrims and the various groups that are in the square. At the end of the audience, the Pope usually leads the Our Father in Latin. It is usually recited or sung. To conclude the general audience, Pope Francis normally imparts his papal blessing upon the pilgrims. This blessing extends also to the loved ones that are sick and are suffering. The Pope blesses religious articles such as rosary beads that the people bring with them to the square. The papal blessing at the end of the audience also extends to us watching on television or listening to this radio broadcast. In general, the Wednesday general audiences are scheduled to start at 9:30, But sometimes they start a bit early, depending on the program that the Pope has that morning. He may be having other programs after the audience. Nevertheless, in general, many people tend to arrive here early, even as early as 2 hours before, in order to get a good seat. And depending on the crowds of that day, sometimes one might need up to about 30 minutes to clear the security checks. By 7:30, the gates are usually open and the security checks begin. As I said, when the general audience starts, Pope Francis will start with the sign of the cross, and then we'll listen to the proclamation of a short scripture reading. And after the proclamation of the reading, the Pope will give a brief teaching, which we call the catechesis. And after that, the brief teaching will be translated in the various languages. And now we prepare ourselves as the Pope has arrived at the stage, the Sagrada, where the events of today will take place. So as we now begin the papal audience shortly with the sign of the cross and the liturgical greetings, we compose ourselves so as that we enter into the spirit of the general audience with the Holy Father, Pope Francis. We'll begin by listening to the various readings, short scripture readings, in French, followed by English, Germany, in the German language, in the Spanish language, Portuguese, Arabic, and also in the Polish language. Pope Francis has now arrived at his seat, and he is due to take his seat, walking slowly there with his walking cane, and I think he's getting better all the time from what we have been seeing of late. The Holy Father now starts the general audience.
Disponiamoci ad accogliere la sua parola e a ricevere la sua benedizione.
In nome del Padre, del Figlio e dello Spirito Santo. La pace sia con voi.
Dal libro del Siracide. Figlio, se ti presenti per servire il Signore, preparati alla tentazione. Abbi un cuore retto e sii costante. Non ti smarrire nel tempo della prova. Accetta quanto ti capita e sii paziente nelle vicende dolorose, perché l'oro si prova con il fuoco e gli uomini ben accetti nel grogiuolo del dolore. È parola di Dio.
So we have heard the first reading in Italian from the book of Sirach, Sirach chapter 2.
Lecture du livre de Ben Sira le Sage. Mon fils, si tu viens te mettre au service du Seigneur, prépare-toi à subir l'épreuve. Fais-toi un cœur droit et tiens bon. Ne t'agite pas à l'heure de l'adversité. Toutes les adversités, accepte-les. Dans les revers de ta pauvre vie, sois patient. Car l'or est vérifié par le feu, et les hommes agréables à Dieu par le creuset de l'humiliation. Parole du Seigneur.
A reading from the book of Sirach. My child, when you come to serve the Lord, prepare yourself for testing. Set your heart right and be steadfast, and do not be impetuous in time of calamity. Accept whatever befalls you, and in times of humiliation, be patient. For gold is tested in the fire, and those found acceptable in the furnace of humiliation. The word of the Lord.
Lesung aus dem Buch Jesu Sirach. Kind, wenn du herantrittst, um dem Herrn zu dienen, mach dich bereit für die Erprobung. Richte dein Herz aus und sei standhaft. Und überstürze nichts zur Zeit der Bedrängnis. Nimm alles an, was über dich kommen mag. Und in den Wechselfällen deiner Erniedrigung halt aus. Denn im Feuer wird Gold geprüft und die anerkannten Menschen im Schmelzofen der Erniedrigung. Wort des lebendigen Gottes.
Lectura del libro del Eclesiástico. Hijo, si te decides a servir al Señor, prepara tu alma para la prueba, endereza tu corazón, sé firme y no te inquietes en el momento de la desgracia. Acepta de buen grado todo lo que te suceda y sé paciente en las vicisitudes de tu humillación, porque el oro se purifica en el fuego y los que agradan a Dios en el crisol de la humillación. Palabra de Dios.
Leitura do livro do Bem-Sirá. Meu filho, se entrares para o serviço de Deus, prepara a tua alma para a aprovação. Endireita o teu coração e sê constante. Não te perturbes no tempo do infortúnio. Aceita tudo o que te acontecer. E tem paciência nas vicissitudes da tua humilhação. Porque no fogo se prova o ouro, e os eleitos de Deus no cadinho da humilhação. Palavra do Senhor.
قراءة من سفر يشوع بن سراخ. يا بني، إن أقبلت لخدمة الرب فأعدد نفسك للمحنة، أرشد قلبك واصبر، ولا تكن قلقا في وقت الشدة، مهما نابك فاقبله، وكن صابرا على تقلبات حالك الوضيع، فإن الذهب يمتحن في النار والمرضيين من الناس في التون الذل. كلام الرب.
Czytanie z mądrości Syracha. Dziecko, jeśli masz zamiar służyć Panu, przygotuj swą duszę na doświadczenia. Zachowaj spokój serca i bądź cierpliwy, a nie trać równowagi w czasie utrapienia. Przyjmij wszystko, co przyjdzie na ciebie, a w zmiennych losach poniżenia bądź wytrzymały, bo w ogniu próbuje się złoto, a ludzi miłych Bogu w piecu poniżenia. Oto Słowo Boże.
So we have listened to the readings, and now the Holy Father will give the catechesis. Dear brothers and sisters, discernment, as we have seen in the previous catechesis, is not primarily a logical procedure. It is based on actions, and actions have an affective connotation which must be acknowledged because God speaks to the heart. Let us then enter into the first affective mode, an object of discernment, desolation. What does this mean, desolation? Desolation has been defined as follows: as the soul being disturbed and agitated, without hope, without love, with which one finds oneself, or lazy, tepid, sad, as if separated from the Creator. The soul feels lazy, tepid, sad, and separated from its Creator. And we have all had this experience. I believe we have all experienced desolation in some way. The problem is how to interpret it, because each tool has something important to tell us. And if we are in a hurry to free ourselves of it, we risk losing this. No one wants to be desolate or sad. We would all like a life that is always joyful, cheerful, and fulfilled. Yet, besides not being possible, that would not be good for us either. Indeed, the change from a life oriented towards vice can start from a situation of sadness, of remorse for what one has done. The etymology of this word remorse is very beautiful. Literally, it is the conscience that bites one, as it were. A conscience that does not permit interior peace. Alessandro Manzoni, in the book The Betrothed, gave us a wonderful description of remorse as an opportunity to change one's life. It is about the famous dialogue between Cardinal Federico Borromeo and the unnamed, who, after a terrible night, presents himself before the cardinal, who addresses him with his surprising words. "You have some good news for me," he says. "Why do you hesitate to say it?" "Good news? I have hell in my soul. Tell me, if you know what good news I have, what would you expect from such a one as I?" "God touches your heart, and it is drawing you to himself," replied the cardinal calmly. God touches our hearts, even in desolation. The man of God knows how to notice in depth what moves in the heart. It is important to learn how to read sadness. All of us, we know sadness. We've had the experience, all of us. But do we know how to read sadness? Can we understand what this particular sadness of today means for me? In our time, sadness is mostly considered negative, as an ill to avoid at all costs. And instead, it can be an indispensable alarm bell for our life inviting us to explore richer and more fertile landscapes that transcend and escapism do not permit. St. Thomas defines sadness as a pain of the soul, like the nerves for the body. It redirects our attention to a possible danger or disregard if we disregard the benefit of it. Therefore, it is indispensable for our health. It protects us from harming ourselves and others. It would be far more serious and dangerous if we did not feel it. The sadness is something like traffic light tells you to stop. There is something ahead. For those, on the other hand, who have the desire to do good, sadness is an obstacle with which the tempter tries to discourage us. In that case, one must act in a manner exactly contrary to what is suggested, determined to continue what one had set out to do.
Se li lasciassimo appena avvertiamo noia e tristezza, non concluderemmo fai nulla.
Think of work, study, or prayer, a commitment undertaken. If we abandon them as soon as we felt boredom or sadness, we would never complete anything. This is also an experience common to the spiritual life. The road to goodness, the gospel reminds us, is narrow and uphill. It requires combat, self-conquest. All of us have had this experience. We must never allow ourselves to be desolate. This is boring. Unfortunately, some people decide to abandon the life of prayer or the choice they have made, marriage or religious life, driven by desolation, without first pausing to consider their state of mind, especially without the help of a guide, a spiritual guide. A wise rule says, do not make changes when you are desolate. It will be the time afterwards, rather than the mood of the moment, that will show the goodness or otherwise of your choices. It is interesting to note in the Gospel that Jesus repels temptation with an attitude of firm resolution. Trials assail us from all sides, but always finding in him this steadfast determination to do the will of the Father, they will fall and cease to hinder this path. In spiritual life, trial is an important moment. As the Bible recalls explicitly, when you come to serve the Lord, prepare yourself for trials. If you want to serve the Lord, prepare yourself. There'll be temptations, there'll be moments of sadness. It is like when a professor examines a student. If he sees that the student knows the essentials of the subject, he does not insist. The student has passed the test. If we know how to traverse loneliness and desolation with openness and awareness, we can emerge strengthened in human and in spiritual terms. No trial is beyond our reach. No trial can be beyond our reach. Don't run away from the trials. Find out what do these trials mean. What does this mean that I'm feeling desolate in this very moment? That way we can go ahead. St. Paul reminds us that no one is tempted beyond his or her ability, because the Lord never abandons us, and with him close by, we can overcome every temptation. If we are ready all the time to rise whenever we are tempted or when we fall, we must never stay. We must never stay firm in the moment of sadness or desolation. We must go ahead. May God bless you in this daily life, in your spiritual life, so that you continue to walk. Thank you. So the Holy Father, continuing with his catechesis on discernment, and today discussing desolation. Having listened to the Holy Father's catechesis, we will now hear the summaries and greetings in the various languages, beginning with French. And now the summary, soon in French.
À la fin de cette audience, nous chanterons le Notre Père en latin. Puis le Saint-Père impartira la bénédiction apostolique. Il l'accorde spécialement aux enfants, aux personnes âgées, aux malades et aux personnes qui sont dans l'épreuve. Il bénira également les chapelets et les autres objets de dévotion que vous avez apportés à cette intention. Voici le résumé de la catéchèse que vient d'exposer Sa Sainteté le Pape François. Chers frères et sœurs, nous avons vu dans les catéchèses précédentes que le discernement n'est pas d'abord une procédure logique. Il concerne les actions qui ont une connotation affective qui doit être reconnue parce que Dieu parle au cœur. Aujourd'hui, nous nous intéressons au mode affectif de la désolation, objet du discernement. Saint Ignace définit ainsi la désolation. Ténèbres de l'âme, agitation intérieure et tentation, envie de choses basses et terrestres. Ainsi, l'âme est portée à la méfiance, elle est sans espoir et sans amour, elle se trouve paresseuse, tiède, triste, et comme séparée de son Créateur et Seigneur. La désolation possède un côté dangereux, certes, mais aussi un côté salutaire pour l'âme, et il convient de déchiffrer cet état d'esprit avec l'aide d'un guide sage. Car pour ceux qui ont le désir de faire le bien, la tristesse est un obstacle par lequel le tentateur veut nous décourager. Le danger serait de s'y complaire, alors qu'en cas de tentation, il faut agir de manière exactement contraire à ce qui est suggéré, sous peine de renoncer à ses engagements. Et cela peut concerner la vie de prière ou encore le choix qui a été fait du mariage ou de la vie religieuse. Cependant, la désolation et la tristesse qui la manifestent peut être un réveil indispensable à la vie spirituelle. Saint Thomas l'a défini comme une douleur de l'âme comparable à celle des nerfs pour le corps. Elle éveille notre attention à un danger possible ou à un bien négligé et peut alors se révéler salutaire. Le changement d'une vie orientée vers le vice peut commencer par une situation de tristesse, de remords pour ce que l'on a fait. Le remords, au sens propre, c'est la conscience qui mord, qui ne donne pas la paix, et la littérature est remplie d'exemples de ce type. Nous avons tous envie de fuir la tristesse, c'est légitime, mais pas avant de l'avoir reconnue et déchiffrée. À présent, Sa Sainteté va saluer en italien les francophones.
Saluto cordialmente i pellegrini di lingua francese, particolari i membri del collegio di difesa della NATO, i cresimati della diocesi di Bayeux-Lucie. E i pellegrini della diocesi di Coutances con i rispettivi vescovi. Il gruppo della Congregazione dell'Oratorio dei Lier, nonché i fedeli della Francia e della Svizzera. Cari amici, ricordate bene, la desolazione deve essere letta e capita. Essa a volte è negativa quando si paralizza e a volte positiva quando si rivela in un campanello di allarme essenziale per la vita. Dio vi benedica.
So Pope Francis, greeting the French pilgrims. I cordially greet the French-speaking pilgrims present at this audience, especially members of NATO Defense College, the confirmation class of young people from the Diocese of Bayeux, Lisieux, with Bishop Jacques Haber, pilgrims from the Diocese of Coutances, with Bishop Laurent Debouche, the group from the Congregation of the Oratories of Here, as well as the many pilgrims from France and Switzerland. Dear friends, remember well, desolation must be read and understood. It is sometimes negative when it paralyzes us, and sometimes it is positive when it turns out to be an essential wake-up call for life. God bless you all. Pope Francis, greeting the pilgrims there. And now we have the summary of the Catechesis of the Holy Father in English and greeting.
The English-speaking visitors and pilgrims present today wish to express to you their sentiments of respect and esteem, and to assure you of their prayers for your ministry as the successor of Peter. At the end of the audience, we will sing together the Our Father in Latin. His Holiness will then impart his apostolic blessing, which he extends in a particular way to the members of your families at home. He also intends to bless religious articles you may have brought for this purpose. And in a special way, his blessing goes to your children, the elderly, and those who are sick. The following is a summary of the Holy Father's catechesis at the beginning of the audience. Dear brothers and sisters, in our continuing catechesis on discernment, we now consider what the spiritual masters call desolation, those moments when we experience interior darkness, unrest, and distance from God and from the consolations of faith. For our spiritual growth, it is important to confront those dark nights of the soul and to discern what the Lord wishes to tell us through them. At times, desolation can be a summons to acknowledge our sinfulness and to embrace God's offer of love and forgiveness. St. Thomas says that our souls, like our bodies, can experience a kind of pain that makes us aware of threats to our spiritual health. At other times, the experience of desolation can be a temptation to grow slack in prayer and in the discipline of the Christian life. Here, too, the great spiritual teachers urge us not to yield to this temptation, but to persevere, confident that by this testing, the Lord will guide us to a fuller understanding of his gracious plan for our lives and a deeper union with him in faith, hope, and love. The Holy Father will now greet us in Italian.
Do il benvenuto a tutti i pellegrini di lingua inglese presenti all'odierna udienza. Specialmente quelli provenienti da Inghilterra, Irlanda, Danimarca, Norvegia, Malta, Indonesia, Filippine e Stati Uniti. Su tutti voi invoco la gioia e la pace di Cristo nostro Signore. Dio vi benedica.
I greet the English-speaking pilgrims taking part in today's audience, especially those from England, Ireland, Denmark, Norway, Malta, Indonesia, the Philippines, and the United States of America. Upon all of you, I invoke the joy and peace of Christ our Lord. God bless you.
So we just listened to the summary of the catechesis in English, and then greetings to English pilgrims. And now, German.
Heiliger Vater, Die Gläubigen deutscher Sprache möchten Ihnen ihre herzliche Zuneigung und aufrichtige Verbundenheit bekunden und versichern Sie zugleich Ihres Gebetes in allen Anliegen Ihres weltweiten apostolischen Dienstes. Zum Schluss der Audienz singen wir gemeinsam das Vaterunser in lateinischer Sprache. Danach wird der Heilige Vater den apostolischen Segen erteilen. Gern schließt er darin ihre Angehörigen ein, besonders die Kinder, die älteren Menschen und die Leidenden. Er segnet auch die Rosenkränze und die übrigen Andachtsgegenstände, die sie dafür mitgebracht haben. Es folgt nun eine Zusammenfassung der Katechese des Heiligen Vaters in deutscher Sprache. Liebe Brüder und Schwestern, zu einer guten geistlichen Unterscheidung bedarf es einer gewissen Kenntnis der eigenen Neigungen und Gefühle, denn sie spielen für unser Handeln meistens eine wesentliche Rolle. Und so möchte ich heute auf den Seelenzustand der Trostlosigkeit zu sprechen kommen. Mit dieser Gefühlslage verbindet man zunächst gewiss nichts Positives, und doch kann sie etwa als ein Alarmsignal Bedeutung gewinnen, indem sie uns auf eine Gefahr oder einen bis dato unbemerkten Mangel in unserem Leben hinweist und uns einlädt, uns wesentlicheren und fruchtbareren Dingen zuzuwenden als bisher. Daneben kann uns die Trostlosigkeit freilich auch vom Guten abhalten, von unseren Aufgaben und Zielen. Deshalb ist der böse Feind stets darauf aus, uns zu entmutigen. Dem entgeht man nur, indem man das, was man sich vorgenommen hat, umso entschlossener verfolgt. Um im Guten voranzuschreiten, braucht es Selbstüberwindung und die Bereitschaft zu kämpfen. Ja, wir werden im Leben immer wieder auf die Probe gestellt, aber doch nicht über unsere Kräfte hinaus versucht werden, denn der Herr ist mit uns. Zusammen mit ihm werden wir bestehen und am Ende sogar geistig und geistlich gestärkt aus solchen Erfahrungen hervorgehen. Der Heilige Vater richtet nun einen kurzen Gruß auf Italienisch an die deutschsprachigen Gläubigen.
Saluto cordialmente i pellegrini in lingua tedesca, in particolare la delegazione dello servizio ospedaliero dell'Ordine di Malta in Austria. Accompagnata da Monsignor Stefan Turnowski, verso ausiliare di Vienna. Lo Spirito Santo ci renda forti nella fede e sempre pronti ad aiutare i nostri fratelli e sorelle bisognosi. Egli doni a tutti noi consolazione e speranza.
The greeting of the Holy Father to German pilgrims. I cordially greet the German-speaking pilgrims, especially the delegates from the Order of Malta Hospitaller Service in Austria, accompanied by their Bishop Stefan Turnowski, Auxiliary Bishop of Vienna. May the Holy Spirit make us strong in faith and always ready to help our brothers and sisters in need. May he give us all consolation and hope. And now it is the turn of Spanish.
Santo Padre, los visitantes y peregrinos de lengua española que participan en esta audiencia desean manifestarle cordialmente sus sentimientos de filial afecto que acompañan con fervientes oraciones por sus intenciones de pastor de toda la Iglesia. Al final de este encuentro se cantará el Padre Nuestro en latín. Después, su Santidad impartirá a todos los presentes la bendición apostólica que extiende complacido a sus familiares, especialmente a los niños y a los ancianos, a los enfermos y a cuantos sufren. Bendice también los rosarios y objetos de devoción que los peregrinos llevan consigo.
Being Spanish himself, the Pope will give the summary himself.
Yeah.
Queridos hermanos y hermanas, en este ciclo de catequesis dedicado al discernimiento, hoy reflexionamos sobre la desolación. Todo lo que hacemos tiene una connotación afectiva y es necesario reconocer, o sea, discernir lo que se mueve en nuestro interior, porque Dios habla al corazón. Cuando los movimientos interiores se caracterizan por la turbación, la tristeza y las tentaciones, cuando sentimos que perdemos la esperanza y nos alejamos de Dios, estamos experimentando la desolación. Nadie quisiera tener que pasar por estos momentos de oscuridad, pero a todos nos llegan, es parte del camino. Y si sabemos leerlos, rezarlos y confrontarlos con un guía espiritual que nos acompañe, pueden ayudarnos a madurar y afrontar la vida de otra manera, más arraigados y firmes en la fe. También es importante, cuando llega la prueba, no hacer mudanza, no cambiar, es decir, permanecer fuertemente unidos al Señor y no desviarnos del camino que nos conduce hasta Él. Así, con la gracia de Dios, podremos fortalecernos y seguir viviendo con mayor paz y libertad. Saludo cordialmente a los peregrinos de lengua.
I cordially greet the Spanish-speaking pilgrims. Next Tuesday we celebrate the Solemnity of All Saints. Let us pray that, following the example of dedication to the will of God, we will not lose heart in moments of desolation, and that we will always know how to trust in Him and in His infinite love that does not abandon us. May Jesus bless you and the Blessed Virgin take care of you. Thank you very much. So the Holy Father gave the, being a Spanish speaker himself, he gave the summary and then greeted the Spanish-speaking pilgrims.
Santo Padre, os fiéis de língua portuguesa desejam testemunhar-lhe filial afeto e sincera fidelidade e rezam por todas as intenções do seu ministério apostólico universal. Leio agora um resumo da catequese que o Santo Padre acaba de propor. Caros irmãos e irmãs, o discernimento que nos vem ocupando nestas catequeses tem a ver sobretudo com as nossas ações e a sua dimensão afetiva, porque Deus fala ao coração. Assim, hoje dedicar-me-ei a refletir sobre a experiência da desolação, que se manifesta numa certa escuridão da alma, que se sente tíbia, preguiçosa e triste. Aprendermos a ler esta tristeza é importante, para evitar que o tentador a utilize como instrumento para nos desencorajar. Quando o desânimo sobrevém, devemos continuar com firmeza o que nos tínhamos proposto fazer. Se abandonássemos o trabalho ou o estudo para sentir tédio ou tristeza, nunca terminaríamos nada. O mesmo sucede na vida espiritual. Infelizmente, por causa da desolação, alguns abandonam a oração e até o matrimónio ou a vida religiosa, sem parar primeiro a interpretar esse estado de espírito com a ajuda de uma pessoa prudente. Para quem quer servir o Senhor, há uma regra de ouro: nunca fazer alterações em tempo de desolação. Antes, aproveitar a desolação como uma oportunidade para converter a vida ou para imitar Jesus naquela firme resolução, com que rejeitou as tentações. Se soubermos atravessar a solidão e a desolação com esta consciência e abertura ao Espírito Santo, podemos sair delas mais fortes, tanto a nível humano como espiritual. Agora o Santo Padre saúda em italiano os fiéis da língua portuguesa.
Saluti pellegrini di lingua portoghese, in modo speciale quelli provenienti da San Salvatore de Bahia, Anicus, Tobaté e San Paolo. Cari fratelli e sorelle, l'altro ieri a Crato, nello stato brasiliano di Ceará, è stata beatificata Benigna Cardoso da Silva, una giovane martire che, osservando la parola di Dio, mantenne pura la sua fede, difendendo la sua dignità. Il suo esempio ci aiuti ad essere generosi discepoli di Cristo. Dalla nostra testimonianza coerente e gioiosa del Vangelo dipende la vita del mondo. Un applauso alla nuova beata. Prego Nossa Signora Aparecida che protegga e cure al popolo brasiliano, che lo liberi dall'odio, dall'intolleranza e dalla violenza.
Eis a tradução das suas palavras. Saúdo os
I greet the Portuguese-speaking pilgrims, especially those from South Salvador da Bahia, Anincus, Taubaté, and São Paulo. Dear brothers and sisters, the day before yesterday in Crato, in the Brazilian state of Ceará, was beatified Benigna Cardoso da Silva, a young martyr who, following the word of God, kept her life pure, defending her dignity. Her example helps us to be generous disciples of Christ. The life of the world depends on our consistent and joyful testimony to the gospel. A round of applause to the new blessed.
Peço a Nossa Senhora Aparecida
that our Lord of Aparecida will protect the people of Brazil and liberate them from the hate of intolerance and violence.
أيها الأب الأقدس يسر المؤمنين الناطقين باللغة العربية الحاضرين هنا أن يعبروا لكم عن مشاعر الاحترام والتقدير وشكرهم البنوي ويرفقونها بصلواتهم الدائمة إلى الله من أجل قداستكم وخدمتكم كخليفة القديس بطرس. في نهاية هذه المقابلة سنرتل معاً صلاة الأبانا باللغة اللاتينية، ثم سيمنح الأب الأقدس جميع الحاضرين البركة الرسولية ويشمل بها جميع أحبائكم وخاصة الأطفال والمتزوجين حديثاً والمسنين والمرضى والمتألمين بآلام شديدة، وسيبارك كذلك المسابح والأشياء التقوية التي يحملها معه كل واحد منكم. إليكم ملخص التعليم المسيحي لقداسة البابا فرانسيس. تكلم قداسة البابا اليوم على مادة من مواد التمييز وهي الكآبة. قال: عرف القديس إغناطيوس دي لويولا الكآبة بأنها ظلام في النفس واضطراب داخلي ونزعة إلى الأمور الدنيا والأرضية وقلق بسبب مختلف الانفعالات والتجارب، وتميل الكآبة بالنفس إلى عدم الثقة وعدم الرجاء والمحبة، ويجد الإنسان نفسه معها كسولاً وفاتراً وحزيناً، وكأنه منفصل عن خالقه وربه. ومع ذلك ففي الكآبة شيء إيجابي، التغيير في الحياة المليئة بالرذائل يمكن أن يبدأ من حالة حزن وتأنيب ضمير، فالكآبة توقظ الانتباه من جديد أمام خطر محتمل أو خير مهمل. لهذا السبب هي ضرورية لحياتنا وتحمينا حتى لا نسيء إلى أنفسنا وإلى الآخرين. وقال قدسته: الذين يريدون أن يعملوا الخير قد يكون الحزن لهم عقبة بها يثبت المجرب عزيمتهم، لكن الإنجيل يذكرنا بأن الطريق نحو الخير ضيق وشاق ويتطلب نضالاً وانتصاراً على الذات. لذلك من المهم للذين يريدون أن يخدموا الرب يسوع ألا يسمحوا للحزن بأن يسيطر عليهم، وعليهم أن يتبعوا قول الحكيم: لا تغير شيئاً وأنت في حالة كآبة. الوقت الذي يمر وليس مزاجك في لحظة الحزن هو الذي يبين لك هل خيارك صواب أم خطأ. إن عرفنا أن نعبر الوحدة والكآبة بانفتاح ووعي، يمكننا أن نخرج أقوى من الجانب الإنساني والروحي. والآن تحية البابا باللغة الإيطالية لأبناء الشرق الناطقين اللغة العربية.
Saluto i fedeli di lingua araba. Non dobbiamo avere paura di provare momenti di tristezza e desolazione, ma essere fiduciosi e sicuri che il Signore non ci abbandona mai e con Lui vicino possiamo vincere ogni tentazione. Signore, vi benedica tutti e vi protegga sempre da ogni male.
I greet the Arabic speaking faithful. We should not be afraid to experience moments of sadness and desolation, but we must be confident and sure that the Lord never abandons us, and with Him near, we can overcome every temptation. May the Lord bless you all and protect you always from all evil.
Ojcze Święty, pielgrzymi z Polski i z innych krajów pragną przekazać Waszej świątobliwości wyrazy synowskiego oddania i szczerej wierności, zapewniając o modlitwie we wszystkich intencjach Jego apostolskiej posługi. Na zakończenie audiencji zaśpiewamy modlitwę Ojcze Nasz po łacinie. Po jej zakończeniu Ojciec Święty udzieli apostolskiego błogosławieństwa, obejmując nim szczególnie dzieci, osoby w podeszłym wieku i dotknięte cierpieniem. Pobłogosławi także różańce i dewocjonalia, jakie pielgrzymi przynoszą ze sobą. Oto streszczenie katechezy Ojca Świętego. Rozeznanie, któremu poświęcony jest ten cykl katechez, związane jest ze sferą uczuć i emocji, ponieważ Bóg przemawia do naszego serca. Dziś skupiamy się na strapieniu, które często pojawia się w procesie rozeznawania. Święty Ignacy Loyola w ćwiczeniach duchowych określił je między innymi jako ciemność w duszy, która jest wówczas smutna i jakby odłączona od swego Stwórcy i Pana. Wszyscy chcielibyśmy wieść życie pełne radości, jednak nie jest to możliwe. Ważne jest, aby nauczyć się odczytywać pojawiający się w nim smutek. Święty Tomasz nazywa go bólem duszy, niezbędnym dla zachowania zdrowia, gdyż może on pomóc nam zwrócić uwagę na możliwe niebezpieczeństwo albo na zlekceważone dobro. Smutek jednak często staje się przeszkodą dla tych, którzy pragną czynić dobro, ponieważ kusiciel chce nas do tego zniechęcić, ale nie możemy dać się zwieść na manowce strapienia. Musimy być wytrwali w modlitwie, w pracy i podjętych zobowiązaniach. Mądra zasada mówi, aby nie dokonywać zmian, gdy jest się strapionym. W życiu duchowym taka próba jest ważnym momentem. Przypominają nam o tym słowa z Księgi Mądrości Syracha. Jeżeli masz zamiar służyć Panu, przygotuj swą duszę na doświadczenie. Jeżeli będziemy starali się przejść świadomie i otwarcie przez czas samotności i strapienia, możemy wyjść z niego umocnieni. Jesteśmy w stanie przetrwać każdą próbę, ponieważ jak mówi nam święty Paweł, nikt nie jest kuszony ponad to, co potrafi znieść, gdyż Pan nas nigdy nie opuszcza. Teraz Ojciec Święty pozdrowi nas, Polaków, w języku włoskim.
Saluto cordialmente tutti i Polacchi. State vivendo la settimana missionaria che quest'anno è accompagnata dalle parole di me sarete testimoni. Con gratitudine penso a tante missionarie e tanti missionari provenienti dal vostro paese che testimoniano il Vangelo in varie parti del mondo. Vi incoraggio a sostenere con le vostre preghiere e con gesti concreti di solidarietà il loro importante servizio. Vi benedico di cuore.
Now we have the greeting of the Holy Father to the Polish-speaking people. I cordially greet all Poles. You are living Mission Week, which this year is being accompanied by the words, "Of me you will be witnesses." With gratitude, I think of the many missionaries from your countries who witness to the gospel in various parts of the world. I encourage you to support with your prayers and concrete gestures of solidarity their important service. I bless you from the bottom of my heart. So we have had the various summaries and greetings in the various languages. And finally, the Holy Father will greet the Italian-speaking pilgrims.
I fedeli di lingua italiana desiderano esprimerle filiale affetto e sincera fedeltà e pregano per tutte le intenzioni del suo universale ministero apostolico. A conclusione di questa udienza canteremo la preghiera del Padre Nostro in latino, terminata la quale il Santo Padre impartirà la benedizione apostolica che estende in modo speciale ai bambini, agli anziani e ai sofferenti. Benedirà anche i rosari e gli oggetti di devozione che ognuno di noi porta con sé.
Assistiamo inorriditi agli eventi che continuano a insanguinare la Repubblica Democratica del Congo.
We continue to witness terrible things that are happening. And in the days before, in the northern Kivu, we have witnessed people who have been killed, and among them was a religious sister who was killed. We pray for the victims. We pray for the Christians and the many inhabitants of those people who are suffering violence. As you know, there's been violence in the region of Congo, eastern part of Congo. I extend a cordial welcome to Italian-speaking pilgrims. In particular, I greet the Associazione Nazionale della Università del Terza Età, which I encourage to continue with this cultural work, to combat the loneliness and the marginalization of the elderly. The elderly are the witnesses of that memory that can help a new generations build a more humane and more Christian future. I greet the representatives of local authorities and schools who are participating in the meeting sponsored by the Biennial Association of Mediterranean Arts and Sciences, together with the Rachelina Ambrosini Foundation. I thank you for your significant commitment to building paths of brotherhood and solidarity with a view to the intellectual and spiritual growth of the area. Let us not forget to pray continuously, always, for the martyred people of Ukraine, that the Lord will protect the people and lead us all to a path of peace. Finally, my thoughts go, as usual, to the young people, the sick, the elderly, and the newlyweds who are present at this audience. To all, I wish to recommend in a special way the recitation of the Holy Rosary. This simple and evocative Marian prayer shows each one the way to follow Christ with trust and generosity. To all of you, my blessing. The Holy Father greeting Italian pilgrims, but before he made an appeal for peace and following some disturbances in Eastern Congo. And now the Our Father in Latin.
Domino Hobisco.
Et cum spiritu tu.
Sit nomen Domini benedictum.
Ex hoc lucetusque in saeculum.
Aiuterium nostrum in nomine Domini.
Qui feci celum et terram.
Benedicta vos omnipotens Deus, Pater, et Filius, et Spiritus Sanctus. Amen. Amen.
So we just received the apostolic blessing there. As I was saying earlier on, just some clarification. The Holy Father made an appeal in Congo where there was conflict and a religious Catholic nun was also killed, Sister Marie Sylvie Kavuke. She was killed in the area of Butembo, Beni, of the DRC in the Congo. And she's among seven other people who were killed, reportedly killed, on Thursday, 20th of October, in the morning, when gunmen attacked a Catholic mission in Maboya village in the Democratic Republic of Congo, and the Holy Father making an appeal for peace in that area. That was just before he greeted the Italian pilgrims. We've come to the end of the general audience for Wednesday today, the 26th. Having received the apostolic blessing, which extends also to your families, wherever you are watching us from and listening us to. My name is Father Paul Samasumo. It has been a pleasure and privilege for me to provide the English language commentary and translation of the text. We now conclude today's live broadcast of Pope Francis's weekly general audience in St. Peter's Square. Remember, you will find summaries of today's Wednesday general audience and that appeal on the Democratic Republic of Congo. You'll find it on our website, vaticannews.va. On behalf of Vatican Media, Enjoy the rest of your day. Laudetur Jesus Christus. Praise be Jesus Christ.